The U.S. has reached a crucial milestone. According to the Missile Defense Agency, the Defense Department's advanced missile tracking satellites logged their first views of a hypersonic flight test. Hypersonic and Ballistic Tracking Space Sensor (HBTSS) satellites were able to track a hypersonic system. MDA didn't disclose the date of the flight, which took off from Wallops Island in Virginia. The agency said in a June 14th statement, "Initial reports show the sensors successfully collected data after launch. MDA will continue to assess flight data over the next several weeks." Viewers may note that the Missile Defense Agency, or MDA, and Space Development Agency, or SDA, are actively working on components of a hypersonic missile defense system to protect against hypersonic weapons and other emerging missile threats. This includes developing the tracking and transport layers of the Proliferated Warfighter Space Architecture (PWSA) and various interceptor programs. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why successful tracking of hypersonic flight by U.S. HBTSS satellites is a crucial development. Let's get started. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted VPN brands worldwide that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte, an industry-leading Big Four auditing firm. NordVPN provides an encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy by preventing external entry to your internet traffic, as well as enabling you to access content that's blocked based on geolocation. Best of all, with one NordVPN account, you can secure up to 6 devices at the same time. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive savings by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. Hypersonic weapons travel at speeds greater than Mach 5, or more than 3,836 miles per hour, and are highly maneuverable, which makes them difficult to track and shoot down. Several types of hypersonic weapons are in development by multiple nations, and some have been fielded too. Russia has developed the Zircon missile using a scramjet engine, and Admiral Gorshkov's frigate is armed with it. Kinzhal missile, used against Ukraine, is an ALBM, or air-launched ballistic missile, that can reach about Mach 9. Russia and China have deployed Avangard and DFZF, respectively, which are hypersonic glide vehicles, or HGVs. The extreme speed of hypersonic weapons and the ability to fly in unpredictable paths give them a much higher probability of penetrating modern air defenses. Essentially, hypersonic weapons combine the speed of ballistic missiles with the maneuverability of cruise missiles. This type of weapon will be very hard to track, let alone intercept. US DoD document has noted, "For example, most terrestrial-based radars cannot detect hypersonic weapons until late in the weapon's flight due to line-of-sight limitations of radar direction. This leaves minimal time for a defender to launch interceptors that could neutralize an inbound weapon." U.S. defense officials have stated that both existing terrestrial and space-based sensor architectures are insufficient to detect and track hypersonic weapons. Former Undersecretary of Defense for Research and Engineering Mike Griffin has noted that hypersonic targets are 10 to 20 times dimmer than what the U.S. normally tracks by satellites in geostationary orbit. The two hypersonic and ballistic tracking space sensor (HBTSS) satellites are part of the Space Development Agency's constellation of spacecraft designed to detect and observe hypersonic weapons or vehicles. The agencies have 10 missile tracking satellites in orbit, 8 from SDA and 2 from MDA. SDA did not immediately confirm whether its satellites also tracked the launch. Although the MDA and SDA sensors were developed through separate programs, future SDA spacecraft tranches will integrate their capabilities by incorporating the medium field of view sensor found on the HBTSS satellites. These HBTSS sensors can track dimmer targets and relay data to interceptors. HBTSS is part of the tracking layer whose goal is to provide global indications, warning, tracking, and targeting of advanced missile threats, including hypersonic missile systems. It will work alongside SDA-developed Wide Field of View WFOV satellites with its Medium Field of View MFOV, with the WFOV queuing data to the HBTSS, which will then provide more specific and quality target data, referred to as fire control data, to linked ground-based interceptors. The constellation aims to expand to 100 satellites, ensuring global coverage of advanced missile launches. Currently, a few spacecraft provide limited coverage. SDA Director Derek Tournier explained to reporters in April the challenge of coordinating satellite positions over test venues for effective tracking. He highlighted that besides monitoring routine Defense Department test flights, the satellites also surveil global hotspots for missile activity during their orbits around the Earth. The U.S. military doesn't have a single operational hypersonic weapon, but is working on several systems. As per reports, the U.S. military is pursuing 9 programs that are dedicated to fielding hypersonic weapons. The HBTSS satellites will aid in this. The flight the satellites tracked was the first for MDA's Hypersonic Testbed, or HTB-1. The vehicle serves as a platform for various hypersonic experiments and advanced components and joins a growing inventory of high-speed flight test systems. Hypersonic weapons will be a key element in future wars, so the U.S. will need to have systems that can reliably defend against hypersonic threats and also build offensive hypersonic platforms that can penetrate enemy defenses. In 2018, America's Government Accountability Office, or GAO, report stated that the U.S. lacks the defenses required to protect against the latest crop of hypersonic weapons being developed by China and Russia. The report states, China and Russia are pursuing hypersonic weapons because their speed, altitude, and maneuverability may defeat most missile defense systems, and they may be used to improve long-range conventional and nuclear strike capabilities. There are no existing countermeasures. As stated by U.S. DoD leaders, hypersonic weapons are a national imperative. In 2021, Michael E. White, Principal Director for Hypersonics, has said the adversaries have increasingly focused on systems that dramatically compress the timelines and the time scale of a tactical battlefield. He indicated that an American portfolio of subsonic and supersonic weapons would be found wanting in a battle. He stated that the U.S. Department of Defense, DOD, has developed the Hypersonics Modernization Strategy that accelerates the development and delivery of transformational warfighting capabilities based on hypersonic systems. In this situation, a successful test of HBTSS satellites is a major milestone.
Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.